Number 5. Michelle Barnes. On New Year's Eve 2007, Michelle Barnes was traveling from Uganda to her home in Colorado after having spent an adventure holiday in Africa. Before she got home, Michelle had already developed a rash, nausea, and a headache. Nevertheless, she spent the next few days in Colorado with her family, friends, and in public places. Unbeknownst to her, Barnes was carrying a contagious virus with a death rate of 25 to 90%. Her symptoms worsened as her body was slowly shutting down, and she began to suffer from multi-system organ failure. Barnes collapsed during a visit to her doctor and was rushed to the emergency room. For the following 12 days, over 200 healthcare professionals treated her with antibiotics and fluids. Barnes started to recover, but no one knew what she'd suffered from. Then, about a year later, Barnes read about a Dutch woman who died of Marburg virus disease after visiting the same cave in Uganda where she'd been. Barnes's delayed diagnosis confirmed her suspicions that she'd battled and survived the disease. Even though she was the first person to bring the virus to the US, no other infections were confirmed. The same was true for the woman who'd taken the disease to the Netherlands. Up next, we go over the discovery of the Marburg virus and the first outbreak associated with it. But first, let's learn more about this deadly viral agent. Today's video was requested by Best Professor. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. The Marburg virus, or Marv, belongs to the Filoviridae virus family, of which Ebola is also a member. It measures about 80 nanometers in width, but has a variable length. When seen under a microscope, it can be coiled or branched and may appear in the shape of a U, a 6, or that of a shepherd's crook. Like others in its family, the Marburg virus causes a potentially deadly hemorrhagic fever called Marburg virus disease. Humans and non-human primates that succumb to it will have typically suffered multiple organ failure. The Marburg virus is considered to be extremely dangerous and requires the highest level of precaution both in a laboratory setting and in case of a potential outbreak. It has been described as the world's deadliest virus and even researched as a chemical weapon. Number 4. Discovery and naming. In 1967, a number of people in Belgrade, Yugoslavia, as well as in the German towns of Frankfurt and Marburg, became violently ill. There were 31 cases of viral infection, which resulted in 7 deaths. No one knew the source of the illness until it was traced back to infected African green monkeys. They'd been brought from Uganda to a company in Marburg called Behringwerke. The company had been founded by Emil von Behring, who was the first person to be awarded the Nobel Prize in Medicine. Behringwerke staff members were the first to contract the disease. They got infected after working with tissue samples from the infected monkeys without wearing proper protective equipment. Secondary infections involved a nurse, doctors, a post-mortem attendant, and a veterinarian's wife. They'd all had direct contact with the fluids, mainly blood, of a primary case. The virus and disease were subsequently named after the town where they were first discovered. Our next listing takes a look at the deadliest outbreak in recent history, but first, let's see where on the map is the virus most prevalent. Even though it carries the name of a German town, Marv is actually endemic to the arid woodlands of equatorial Africa. It's been reported in Uganda, Angola, Kenya, South Africa, and the Democratic Republic of the Congo. Although not endemic, it was also found in the Soviet Union, but we'll get to that later on. Most of the infections that have occurred were associated with people working in mines or visiting natural caves. Old world fruit bats seem to play a major role in the transmission and natural maintenance of the virus. Only in the original 1967 outbreak have other animals been linked to Marv. It's still unclear whether bats are the hosts of the virus or if they serve as intermediates after being infected by other animals. Number 3. Angola outbreak. So far, the deadliest Marburg virus outbreak on record took place in Angola from 2004 to 2005. Out of the 252 people who'd contracted Marburg virus disease, 227 lost their lives. There was a combination of logistical and social factors which contributed to the elevated fatality rate. One was a shortage of medical professions. At the time of the outbreak, Angola had a population of roughly 19 million people but only about 1,200 doctors. There were situations in which entire provinces had as few as two. The country's roads and other aspects of infrastructure were left in shambles after decades of civil war. There was also a massive shortage of personal protective equipment for healthcare workers. When a Doctors Without Borders team arrived at a hospital, which was at the center of the outbreak, they found that it operated without water and electricity. Because of the disease's association with death, locals treated healthcare workers with hostility and refused getting treatment. Coming up, we're going to take a look at how Marburg virus disease can kill you, and later on, we'll learn how one government tried to weaponize it. Official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. Some of it is to die for. As Marv, or its lesser known relative to the Raven virus or RAV, enter the body, they cause Marburg virus disease, also known as Marburg hemorrhaging fever. The incubation period is on average between 5 to 9 days. First symptoms include a high fever, a severe headache, rashes, vomiting, diarrhea, and abdominal pain. Within a few days, the disease progresses to include shortness of breath, edema, encephalitis, and conjunctivitis. The combination of symptoms may cause sufferers to become confused, delirious, and aggressive. After the onset of bleeding symptoms, the sufferer will either recover or die. Blood may leak from the gums, nose, or appear in the form of ecchymosis, a subcutaneous bleeding spot similar to bruises. The sufferer may experience bloody stools or vomiting blood. A state of convalescence follows as multiple organs begin to shut down. Death, on average, occurs within 2 weeks after the onset of the first symptoms. Even if it doesn't kill a patient initially, Marv is known to persist in the body and may reactivate or be transmitted through sperm and even breast milk or amniotic fluid. Number 2. Research as a biological weapon. We've previously mentioned that Marburg virus disease has also been detected in the Soviet Union. It didn't occur naturally, however, as it was part of a biological weapons research program. At least three separate institutions were researching warfare applications of the deadly virus during the Cold War. There was also one accident at a facility in Koltsovo in 1988, which resulted in the death of a researcher named Nikolai Ustinov. The research was highly classified, so it's still unclear how far the Soviets got towards a weaponized version of the virus. According to biological warfare expert and Soviet Union defector Ken Alabek, the progress was indeed substantial. He claimed that a Marv-containing weapon was tested at a base in the Kazakh Soviet Socialist Republic on the territory of present-day Kazakhstan. Before we move on to the country with the most Marv outbreaks, let's see what can be done to survive Marburg virus disease. As of the making of this video, there is no cure or proper vaccine available for Marburg virus disease. An early diagnosis is the best chance of survival if you're infected. Immediate supportive treatment includes antibiotics to combat secondary infections and balancing fluids to prevent dehydration. It's also important to maintain oxygen levels and control blood coagulation. In the first stage of the disease, drugs should be administered to prevent the formation of blood clots. Later in the infection, procoagulants should be administered to control excessive bleeding. Since the disease has a high fatality rate, prevention is the best course of action. This means avoiding the places where the virus exists in nature, as well as avoiding skin-to-skin contact with people you believe may be infected. Marv doesn't get transmitted by aerosol during MVD outbreaks. Its primary means of transmission among humans is through excretions, bodily fluids, and possibly contaminated materials and utensils. The virus requires biosafety level 4 equivalent containment, the highest safety level available. Those working with viral samples in a laboratory setting should receive proper training in multi-layered safety protocols. Number 1. 2017 outbreak in Uganda. Uganda seems to be ground zero for the Marburg virus as the country with the most recorded outbreaks. Nearly every instance of MVD traveling across intercontinental lines has been traced back to the African country. Five separate outbreaks from 2007 to 2017 have involved roughly 24 cases of human infection and 14 confirmed deaths. Hundreds of individuals were under surveillance for the virus through contact tracing. In the most recent outbreaks, the index case, meaning the first person known to have contracted the disease, was a game hunter. The man lived near the mountain caves where the bats harboring Marburg viruses dwelled. He transmitted the disease to another family member, and she died as well. They were, however, the only two confirmed fatalities in the 2017 outbreak. In recent years, the Ugandan Ministry of Health has collaborated with international organizations like UNICEF, the World Health Organization, and Doctors Without Borders to improve the way the country deals with viral outbreaks. Thanks for watching. Be sure to click on one of the links on your screen for more videos.